These were the challenges. Now we will move to the sizing optimization of these type of systems. In initial sizing, basically in conceptual stage. So, because challenges is that you have to take care of all the different aspects of the affecting parameters simultaneously. So, the requirement of there is a design methodology requirement. So requirement should be such that whenever we feed the operational parameter or design parameter, like wind speed, because wind speed at that height will be different, and even for the it will be different for the different lat long at the same height, say about 20 kilometers, the wind speed at the Mumbai will be different from Delhi. So it should be we should consider that solar irradiance will be different at the different location. Whenever we will talk about altitude, latitude and longitude, so each location at that height will be different, power available will be different, that will affect our the whole systems, because if power available is high, you will need a lesser solar cells, you will need a lesser power storing device. Geometric coverage ratio. What is geometric coverage ratio? Can anybody tell? Geometric coverage ratio. Any guess? No guess. Aap log to bahut guess karte hain. It is simply a ratio of something. Coverage must be an area. So the ratio of two areas, which are the simple that basically two areas we have to consider, envelope areas, and another thing is solar cell area. So because the envelope area will affect our structural mass, and solar area will affect the power output. So it is basically a ratio of solar area divided by the area of solar area divided by the envelope area. That is called a geometric coverage ratio. Discharging time is the time when the power, direct power from sun is not available, and you have to supply power from the battery. That is the discharging time, which will be a larger in winter, and it will be a smaller in a summer. And it will vary around the globe due to the latitude and longitude. Okay, na? Of standard temperature, because temperature at that height will affect the buoyancy as well as the power output. And purity of LTA gas will affect the buoyancy. And efficiency of cells, that is another major research area as general. Because the highly efficient solar cells will result a very low system weight. So it is how much maximum efficiency is nowadays we get from solar cells? Any guess? Maximum efficiency of the solar cell? 20%? It is 8 to 10%. और अगर लोकल है तो और कम होगा. पीपल आर रिसर्चिंग इन दे आर क्लेम दे हैव क्लेम दैट 40-45%. सो इट विल बी अ बिग रिसर्च आउटपुट. यू नो द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ एफिशिएंसी, सोलर सेल एफिशिएंसी. टू लाइट अप अ सिंगल बल्ब यू विल नीड अ लार्जर सोलर एरिया. Because larger solar area, it will accumulate, and 8% of that will be converted and it will light up. So if the efficiency is high, say it is about 100%, and the output is how much? 500 watt per meter square. So if we place a 1 meter square, you will get a 500 watt. But the 8% of that actually a problem. So a big solar plate is required to light up the small lantern at the night. So the metallurgy requirement is this, and it should be such that at the end, while we give the payload requirement as well as the power requirement, it should give the size of airship. What is the required size to overcome that payload as well as to power? Metallurgy design should be able to give. And most feasible shape for different requirement, the shape will be different. It will vary, as I said earlier. For the, if the power is more, power output is more, and it is more important, then it may might ends with the some another shape, maybe a 3D. Because when you will consider only power requirement, what type of shape you will proposed? Any guess? Suppose we have to bother only about power. Huh? How we can maximize that power output? Maximum area, but maximum area with a different location orientation will not result a maximum output. So it should be such that at over the day, the vector of the normal area vector of the profile of the should be with a 0 degree angle, ideally with the solar radiation angle. You get the point. So it should be such that at each time it should be the 0 degree, and you will get a maximum output. Otherwise, cos theta is involved and it will bring down. Larger the cos theta, minimum will be the output, irradiance, at least input. So, but there is another problem as well, drag. So we have to take care of drag as well. We have to take care of payload as well. So what will be the optimum shape which will maximize the power output as well as payload output, payload available payload as well as the minimum drag. So the shape should be like that. And what will be the different mass component of the different mass of the different component, like propulsion systems mass and the structural weight and storing energy, battery weight. It should be able to give, design methodology should be such that. So basically a sizing methodology proposed that we can see, start from here and give some, for the given payload and power requirement, give some random length and calculate with the given parameter, because the location you know, and at that location, you know that at the particular time as well, because over the time, over the date, it will vary. Suppose today is the, what date? 8th of April. The energy available at that height in Mumbai, it will be different when we consider at some other date. So for a given location and date, the wind speed is available, irradiance available, temperature, pressure, and from that we have to calculate all these systems, volumes, and the volume will drive the payload, and if it's either in surface area with the size, and surface area of airship will lead to the drag and as well as the system's weight, and we have to finally check whether the power requirement is met or not. And if it is not, then you have to go back and change the length. And payload and power check, both should be fulfilled. Otherwise, you have to go and change the length. Do the iteration, and if all the power requirement or payload are met, then end with the calculation. That is for initial sizing. It is not in optimum sizing. So for a simplicity, we can look at this problem. So suppose this is actually an NPL shape driven by the two parabola, you know, NPL shape. How NPL shape is defined? How NPL shape is defined? Acha, you say some shapes of the airship, you know, different shapes of the airship, standard shape, profile. There are some standard profile of the airship, no? Normal airship, GNVR, and double ellipsoid is actually an NPL shape. It is a combination of two half ellipsoid with the same minor axis and different major axis. So here this is different from this length, same major axis, and is basically a ratio of root 2. So we consider that, and this is the area required. Suppose the XF is the final position of the solar cells and XS is the start position. So the length is will be XF minus XS, and the angular coverage is zeta array. Zeta or psi, what you used to say? So whatever this. So the angular, so complete area you can calculate. So let us, these are the design variable, A, B. B is the radius of the airship at maximum diameter. A is the semi-major axis, and when you will multiply with the root 2, it will give the other side area, length. And so 1, 2, 3, 4, and when you add A plus root 2A, it will lead to the L, total length of the airship, and the psi. So five, basically a five design parameters, A, B, and zeta array, and XS and XF. So these are the initial values. For initial, we have get from initial design. Now we have to optimize, because the location will put XS and XF will affect the output. We have to maximize that. And coverage, how much coverage will be required to fulfill the power. So for initial sizing, what you have said in the design, this is the parameters for initial sizing. For to fulfill the power requirement and payload requirement, you will need a length of around 200 meters, and with these types of this angle starting and ending total length of the solar cells. And the other output parameters for initial sizing, you can see for these are the input parameters, these are the output parameters. So payload mass of 1000 kg and payload power of 1 kW. These calculations are made, and what we are getting is you can see the size of to produce such payload and power. You will need around 137 or 138 meter length of the airship. And the thrust and the power required to overcome the thrust will be 31 kilowatt. And the mass breakdown, as I said, methodology should be able to give the mass breakdown of the systems. So you can see around 50% of the weight is of the systems is due to its structure. That's where the problem. Whenever we will decrease the GSM with the keeping the same strength, it will give a better, a good result, good output. And the storage weight is around 1/3 of the total system weight. This is another problem. So when will we maximize the storing capacity of the RFC or lithium ion battery, it will minimize that. It will lower the system weight and we will get a higher payload. So these are the sensitivity analysis, how different output parameters will be driven with the change of the input parameters. That is actually a sensitivity of design parameters. So you can see this is the weight, percentage weight due to the RFC and the solar cells. So whenever we'll increase the energy density of RFC, that means it can store same energy with the lower weight itself, its weight. That is the better. So whenever we will increase the density capacity of RFC, the percentage weight of the system will go down. these trends you can see. Are you able to see this? No. अब पीछे मुड़ के देखना पड़ेगा. एंड अनदर थिंग इज द व्हेन एफिशिएंसी ऑफ द सोलर सेल विल इंक्रीज द सिस्टम्स वेट विल गो डाउन. यू गेट द पॉइंट. सिस्टम्स वेट विल गो डाउन. नाउ सी द वेरिएशन ऑफ बॉयंसी विद द लेंथ. This is the length, this is the weight of airship, and this is the length variation. Are you able to see? No. I should have designed the light background. So you can observe one interesting thing is that there is a minimum length of the airship required to overcome its own weight, and below that length the system will be it will not even overcome its own weight, and you have to get extra payload to carry the systems, another systems. That is interesting. And the another variation is that as simple volume with the payload with the volume, as the payload is driven by the volume, and this is a linear relationship between the payload and the volume. So move on to the next slide. We see the effect of wind speed, how much it affects at that height. It is for 10 to 25 meters per second for the same size of airship, say around 500 length, and we are getting a very low drag. And when the wind speed we increase to 25 meters per second, the drag is about 8 folds. That is the significance of wind speed, and because the very big size, and it is directly the half rho v square, right? Now half rho v square. It will go a square with the velocity. To overcome the power, and because power is required to propel the airship to withstand with the drag and to fulfill the power requirement by the payload, so there is a minimum requirement of the length or size of the airship which will actually fulfill the power required. So and below that length, say around 175 or 190 meters, system is underpowered. So now with this, earlier it was results for initial sizing, and now we have to optimize. We put the system's methodology in optimization to get the best result. So the formulation is such that total mass, we have to minimize the total mass of the systems while fulfilling the requirement of payload as well as power required. So for the baseline case, when we have not considered the optimization, the baseline case was these for the same power requirement or payload requirement, or after optimization we are getting this. So the change we can see actually the purpose of optimization. So are you getting, or I think you are getting bored. Not you are not getting a point. So it is almost. So on the last slide, it is not the least, but in last year we have seen in Times of India about the high altitude airships. So research are going on over the globe, and it is a very potential area. So that was talk. Thank you.